Hey everyone, welcome to another video. In this video we're going to have a look at two authors in fact, Joseph Campbell and Ernest Becker. I think they're very interesting to discuss together because Ernest Becker in his book The Denial of Death argued that mankind is going through a very serious crisis, and I believe that Joseph Campbell might actually have a solution to this crisis. So in that sense they're very, very interesting to analyze together. In this video, we will first analyze what this crisis that mankind is going through actually is, and we will explain how it came about and why we cannot really solve it in our current society. And then we will look at some of the solutions, and then especially the solution that Joseph Campbell offers. So in short, the crisis that man is going through, according to Ernest Becker, is that we need to be a hero, and our current society is not really fulfilling this need because we have basically become too developed or too smart in a sense to fulfill this need. So in his book The Denial of Death, Ernest Becker explained that according to him, man's tragic destiny is his need to be a hero. According to him, he must desperately justify himself as an object of primary value in the universe. He must stand out. Be a hero, make the biggest possible contribution to world life, show that he counts more than anything or anyone else. Well, according to Ernest Becker, everyone really wants to be a hero. And, well, they basically want this to, in order to provide themselves with self-worth and prove to the world that he or she counts. And although everyone desires to be a hero, nobody openly admits to this desire, which is quite curious according to Ernest Becker. When we appreciate how natural it is for man to strive to be a hero, how deeply it goes in his evolutionary and organismic constitution, how openly he shows it as a child, then it's all the more curious how ignorant most of us are, consciously, of what we really want and need. According to Ernest Becker, in our current age, although we don't openly admit to it, we still try to satisfy this need, albeit in a less obvious way. For example, according to Ernest Becker, we disguise our struggle by piling up figures in a bank account or by having only a little better home in the neighborhood, a bigger car, brighter children, but underneath traps the ache of cosmic specialness, no matter how we mask it in concerns of a smaller scope. And according to Ernest Becker, an important part of the description of a society is that it is a hero system. According to him, the fact is that this is what society is and always has been, a symbolic action system, a structure of statuses and roles, customs and rules for behavior designed to serve as a vehicle for earthly heroism. Therefore, it also doesn't really matter whether a culture is primitive, according to our opinion, or whether it's religious or scientific. It all doesn't really matter because they all serve the same purpose. It is still a mythical hero system in which people serve in order to earn a feeling of primary value. A temple, a cathedral, a totem pole, a skyscraper, a family that spans three generations. The hope and belief is that the things that man creates in society are of lasting worth and meaning, that they outlive or outshine death and decay, that man and his products count. Though these different societies does all serve the same purpose, according to Ernest Becker, they differ in the extent to which they succeed in satisfying this human need for heroism. And according to Ernest Becker, the societies that we would consider to be primitive are actually a lot more successful in this regard than our current society. Ernest Becker really questions whether our society can actually fulfill this need. So he writes, "The crisis of modern society is precisely that the youth no longer feel heroic in the plan for action that their culture has set up. They don't believe it's empirically true to the problem of their lives and times. We are living a crisis of heroism that reaches into every aspect of our social life." Becker believes that this development can be characterized by an increase in, for example, the rise of political activism, more extreme political viewpoints, the rise of anti-heroes, and also a negative view towards traditional religions. As we have seen so far, according to Ernest Becker, everybody basically wants to be a hero, but our society is failing at fulfilling this need. So the question that we can then ask is how we can actually solve this crisis. And in order to do so, We can look at the societies in the past that managed to fulfill this desire a lot better. As I mentioned, the societies that we call primitive, they're actually really successful in this regard. And for this, we can have a look at Joseph Campbell, because I believe he provides some answers to this question. We can ask the question, how is it possible that societies in the past managed to satisfy this need for heroism inherent in humans a lot better? And according to Joseph Campbell, this is the case because myths and mysteries played an important role in satisfying this desire in the past. So in his book, The Hero with a Thousand Faces, he indicated that nature, for example, used to be an important source of mystery that created a sense of heroism for mankind. So he wrote, "For the primitive hunting peoples of those remotest human millennia, when the saber-toothed tiger, the mammoth, and the lesser presences of the animal kingdom were the primary manifestations of what was alien, the source at once of danger and sustenance. The great human problem was to become linked psychologically to the task of sharing the wilderness with these beings." So basically, by this kind of struggle with the animal kingdom, the people in those times, they had some kind of unconscious identification with these beings, which then became an important part in of their myths and rituals and really shaped their community. And this was the same for example, cultures that were supporting themselves on plant food. So they based their rituals around the plants. The life rituals of planting and reaping were identified with those of human procreation, birth and progress to maturity. This identification with the animal and the plant world, they really led to a cohesive society, according to Joseph Campbell. He argued that the animals became the tutors of humanity. Through acts of literal imitation, such as today appear only on the children's playground, an effective annihilation of the human ego was accomplished, and society achieved a cohesive organization. However, as soon as mankind started to, well, progress, the animal and plant world, they kind of started to lose their mystery. According to Joseph Campbell, both the plant and the animal worlds, however, were in the end brought under social control, whereupon the great field of instructive power shifted to the skies, and mankind enacted the great pantomime of the sacred moon king, the sacred sun king, the hierarchic planetary state, and symbolic festivals of the world regulating spheres. Similarly to the animal and the plant kingdom, the moon and the sun eventually also lost most of their mystery. Today, all of these mysteries have lost their force, their symbols no longer interest our psyche. Such, the problem that occurs is that we can no longer achieve a feeling of heroism by struggling with these great forces of nature. However, as indicated by Ernest Becker, we still really desire such a struggle. And therefore, in our current society, we kind of try to fulfill these desires by, for example, acquiring riches, by building skyscrapers, or like I'm doing, trying to make YouTube videos. Sadly, these attempts are not as successful as those of more primitive societies in the past, and they also don't really lead to a cohesive society as they used to do. Another question that we can ask ourselves is whether science can play a role for us in fulfilling this desire for heroism, because as we've seen, science can also be considered the largest contributor to the end of the importance of myths and religions. So as such, we can ask ourselves whether science can be a substitute for these myths and mysteries. In order to answer this question, we can make a small detour to the book that we've discussed in the last video, The Myth of Sisyphus, written by Albert Camus. Sadly, according to Albert Camus, science does not really fill this gap of myths and religions. And instead, according to him, it might even result in an ever-increasing separation from nature. So he wrote, "Yet all the knowledge on earth will give me nothing to assure me that this world is mine. You describe it to me and you teach me to classify it. You enumerate its laws, and in my thirst for knowledge, I admit that they are true." And it's basically impossible for science to fill this gap, because all of these facts that science provides us with, they're almost impossible to grasp in a literal sense, according to Camus. So he wrote, "At the final stage, you teach me that this wondrous and multicolored universe can be reduced to the atom, and that the atom itself can be reduced to the electron. All this is good and I wait for you to continue, but you tell me of an invisible planetary system in which electrons gravitate around a nucleus. You explain the world to me in an image. I realize then that you have been reduced to poetry. So in this sense, it can be argued that the more we know, the more we kind of lose touch with the world, and the less we can use the world as an inspiration for our daily lives. So science explains the world in an image which we, as opposed to the images created by myths and mysteries, cannot really grasp. I believe that the major difference between our current society and more primitive societies in the past can actually be found in this connection with nature and the world in general. So in the past, our connection with the world and the myths and mysteries that were involved with living so intimately with nature, they were an important source of heroism. And in more primitive societies, people were really connected with the world and with nature. And in our modern societies, this is no longer the case. So nature has lost most of its mystery. And actually, most of us can go about our lives without any knowledge of or any connection with nature. And as we've seen, science is not really a contender for increasing our connection with the world. Instead, it can be argued that it will only remove us further away from our connection with this world. So in another famous book, The Inner Reaches of Outer Space, Joseph Campbell described myths as productions of human imagination. Their images, consequently, though derived from the material world and its supposed history, are, like dreams, revelations of the deepest hopes, desires and fears, potentialities and conflicts of the human will, which in turn is moved by the energies of the organs of the body, operating variously against each other and in concert. Every myth, that is to say, whether or not by intention, is psychologically symbolic. Its narratives and images are to be read, therefore, not literally, but as metaphors. In this sense, myths can kind of explain our role and purpose on Earth and also provide us with a sense of meaning. And at the same time, they can also be an important source of heroism because they result in a sense of us being of value in the universe. So the question that follows is what we can do to regain our sense of heroism in a world where we do not have these myths and mysteries anymore. First of all, it's important to notice that we cannot really go back to our old days anymore. Instead, we must kind of find a new way to give us this feeling of heroism. So Joseph Campbell wrote, "Obviously, this work cannot be wrought by turning back or away from what has been accomplished by the modern revolution. For the problem is nothing if not that of rendering the modern world spiritually significant." So we cannot go back to the old way, instead we have to find a new way. Joseph Campbell suggests that we should turn elsewhere for spiritual significance. He wrote, "The hero deed to be wrought is not today what it was in the century of Galileo. Where then there was darkness, now there is light. But also, where light was, there now is darkness. The modern hero deed must be that of questing to bring to light again the lost Atlantis of the coordinated soul." In this sense, we might argue that the solution to this problem is the creation of a new myth. And this myth would then not be focused on the external world, as we did in the past, so towards the plant world, the animal kingdom. Instead, it would be focused inward to our, well, internal world. Therefore, Joseph Campbell wrote, "Man is that alien presence with whom the forces of egoism must come to terms, through whom the ego is to be crucified and resurrected, and in whose image society is to be reformed." According to Joseph Campbell, this new myth or this new image should not be based on the narrow-minded ideals of a single nation or a single culture. Instead, it should be something that connects all of mankind. So he wrote, "For the ideals and temporal institutions of no tribe, race, continent, social class, or century can be the measure of the inexhaustible and multifariously wonderful divine existence that is the life in all of us." Although it's important that this image or this myth should be the same for all of mankind, and the symbols that represent the image might actually differ depending on local circumstances and cultures. So Campbell wrote, "Therefore, it is necessary for man to understand and be able to see that through various symbols the same redemption is revealed. The way to become human is to recognize the alignments of God and all of the wonderful modulations of the face of man. That was quite a long and I think also quite complicated discussion. I think that from the ideas put forward by Ernest Becker and Joseph Campbell, we can conclude that humans still need myths and mysteries to provide us with a sense of meaning and significance, basically a sense of heroism. The more our societies have developed, the less we are basically unable to receive this feeling of importance from the traditional myths and mysteries that our more primitive societies had in the past. So in a sense, the world has lost most of its mystery, and as such we are kind of going through a crisis. I think that Joseph Campbell proposes a very interesting solution to this crisis. So he proposes us to derive a new universal image or myth from the true crucial mystery that still exists. And this would be mankind himself, basically. According to Joseph Campbell, it is up to man himself to create such a new image. So he wrote, "It's not society that is to guide and save the creative hero, but precisely the reverse. And so every one of us shares the supreme ordeal, carries the cross of the Redeemer, not in the bright moments of his tribe's greatest victories, but in the silences of his personal despair." That's a very interesting quote to wrap up this video. Please let me know what you thought about it in the comments. And I'm curious to hear whether you agree with Joseph Campbell, that this kind of new myth will be a solution. And if so, I'm also curious to hear what you would think would be a good new myth for mankind to kind of guide us through our existence in this world. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video as well.